Is a periodic password change a good thing? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question on something that I think has been a bit of lore for probably decades. I read many articles, including some on Ask Leo, that recommend that people should change their passwords from time to time. But what is good practice in this respect? Should it be related to frequency of use? For instance, some passwords are used frequently, some less often, and some rarely. Or should it be related to the level of security needed? For instance, passwords for online banking are more sensitive than passwords for magazine subscriptions. Good practice in a corporate environment seems to be to force network and other password changes every 30 days or so. This would seem like overkill in the home environment. It could result in some accounts being accessed more often to change a password than to do anything else. Unless you get into a good routine, like when you do data backups, password changes will only get done sporadically, if at all. Do you have a view on how to build such a routine? Opinions? Yes, I have opinions. Like you say, routines for things like this are really hard to set up. If they're not automated, it's easy to forget them. Automation may often be the answer, but it's not always available, at least not in a convenient form. And before we even get to that, I want to talk about that you should change your password periodically rule of thumb. The concept that I maintain is that there's nothing about the age of a password that makes it lose quality over time. Very strictly, that's not true, because the 8-character password you created 20 years ago is of lower quality than the 20-character passwords that you might be or hopefully creating today. But we are talking about shorter time frames, like that every 30 days or every 90 days. Here's the thing. The vast majority of password-based hacks are due to weak passwords, sharing passwords, phishing attacks, and technology-based compromises like malware, especially keyloggers. Changing your password doesn't help any of those. Hackers will, in those cases, get your current password without regard to its age. Periodically changing your password adds a tiny, tiny layer of security that avoids less common threats, such as the compromise of an old database of accounts and passwords. These things happen, but not nearly as often as the more common compromises I just mentioned. Even when they do, more often than not, your password's never exposed because of how the databases are maintained. Here's how to keep your passwords and your accounts safe in priority order. To begin with, choose a good password to start. Longer is better. Like I said, if you're still using an 8 or even a 12-character password, it's probably not long enough. Passwords should, today, be at least 16 or 20 characters or longer. 20 characters is what I use, and that will stand the test of at least the next couple of decades, from what I understand. Tell no one. I'm really surprised at how often people share their passwords, and then they're surprised when their friend is no longer their friend, or their spouse is no longer their spouse, and suddenly their email, their Facebook, or other accounts get compromised. Don't write it down. Yes, make it a good password, but either make it something you can remember so you don't have to write it down, or use a password manager to remember it for you. Never, ever reuse passwords. When you reuse passwords, you allow the compromise of one account to affect all of the other accounts using the same passwords. Hackers know that people do this, and they absolutely try to see if you're one of those people. This might be one of the most common ways accounts get compromised of late. If you're hacked, secure your account. Yes, that's the time to change your password, absolutely. And also realize that changing your password in that situation might not be enough. And finally, consider adding two-factor authentication. Like you said, some accounts are important. Some accounts are super important. For those accounts that support it, two-factor authentication will prevent hackers from getting in even if they know the password. So, when should you change your password? There are situations where you do. For example, change your password if you suddenly realize you've still got that old, poor 8-character password, or it's easy to guess, or it's otherwise too short. Just choose a better password. Change your password at the first hint of strange account activity. If your account has been hacked, doing this is step one. Then, of course, take additional steps to secure your account. It's never not okay to change your password. If you have even a hint of something that you don't understand, changing your password is a fine, fine thing to do. Change your password if you find out that the service has in fact been compromised. For example, if you read about your favorite online store getting hacked, immediately change your password at that online store. If you've been using an email service as the alternate account for one of your other accounts, and you hear that that service gets hacked, make sure to change that other account's password as well. So, automating the process. As you can tell by now, it's my opinion that periodic password changing isn't nearly as important as we've been led to believe. Perhaps you don't agree, and you still want to set up a system, as the person asking a question did. So, how do you automate this process? The only approach I can think of is to set a reminder on your calendar. The problem is that changing your password on all of your accounts, I have over 350, it's just not practical. So, as a result, we skip it. Technology is another approach. There are systems, including Windows itself, that can be configured to require you to change your password according to some set schedule. The problem here, of course, is that most password-requiring systems don't include this type of functionality. For example, the major free email providers don't. Now, I want to leave you with a story because, honestly, it, to me, exemplifies of how ineffectual a forced periodic password change can be. A company had configured its Windows logins to require a new password every 30 days. It had also configured the system so you couldn't reuse your last 5 passwords, and you had to come up with a new one every 30 days. So, one individual, every 30 days, would change his password 6 times in a row, so that the current password, the password that he started with, would be forgotten by the system, and he could use it again. Yes, he changed his password 6 times in a row just so he could end up with the same password unchanged. People can be very innovative at getting what they want. And in this case, that periodic password change that was enforced not only didn't make a difference for this person, but even across the organization, wasn't really adding the value that I believe would have warranted it. Use good password hygiene. Do the things I've talked about above, but there's really no need to change your password only because a certain amount of time has passed. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/4294. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.